running your own race. Some people might say that you spend far too much time training in the gym. Little do they know that that time that you spend in the gym is a process, not an instant result, but a process, a journey of mastery, of perfection that you crave. It is a process that requires days, hours, weeks, months, years, and even decades of continual progressive training to reach that level of mastery and perfection that you crave. Whenever you see a bodybuilder on a competition stage, guaranteed, they have been training continuously, progressively to achieve the physique that they've been desiring for years and years and years and years. An Olympian, just to reach the Olympic level, been training for at least 10 years, decades, starting from 10, 12, 14 years old. So by the time they get to the Olympics at 20, 22, 24, they've had 10 years of experience, 10 years of training, 10 years. That's what it takes. That's what it requires. And it's a frustrating process. You have to be willing to go through the frustration, the downfall, the agony, the lows. There are going to be days where you feel like crap, where you don't want to go to the gym and lift and run on the track and swim in the pool, throw a baseball, go to practice, whatever sport or endeavor it may be for you. But that's what it takes, getting up and going when you don't want to. That's the process of mastery. It's the journey. It's the process of experiencing, of investing the time, because that is what is required, the investment in the time, in the journey, in training. This isn't an instant gratification. It's not something that comes really quick, but is a lifelong commitment, because minimal effort produces minimal results. And this kind of investment can only be a full lifelong commitment. So before you tell somebody that they're wasting their time or they're spending too much time, let them run their own race. Be encouraging, because training for them is their purpose. Running your own race.